company. Our HHT has the staff and that might
oh.
That may make some sergeants
major
fucking
happy. Well, I like to think we got
that's pretty good at it.
Even there, but here they're able to do that because they're already a higher capacity DTRAC, higher capacity quarters.
Social distancing.
I told him to hit the jackpot.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So will we help prevention? Everybody got to go through that door.
All their linen and everything will be turned in.
For helping take care of the soldiers. We're just in a real trick right now with COVID. I know, you know, it's always struggling with it.
Plastic shield jump.
You're probably aware that we just took a 2-week pause to training. That's because we assessed that we needed some time to reset our footprint in the training base. We need to revamp our program of instruction. We need to make sure we trained and educated the cadre here so they can safeguard the soldiers. And I think that history will show that training your Dr. Crew right here at the Great Fort Benning, they've really done a phenomenal job. And our numbers of COVID, I can't discuss specifics, are extraordinarily low. And all that is playing itself out all across training your Dr. Crew. I couldn't be prouder of the work that the folks have done right here at Fort Benning Charge. This is my second home. I love coming back to Fort Benning. I'm just overwhelmed by what I've seen from the officers, the non-commissioned officers, the civilians, and heck, even the AFES folks are bending over backwards to bring the support, necessary support out to the soldiers here. It's hit America hard. COVID has hit the United States Army very hard. But I tell you, TRADOC is up and fighting like a tiger right now, and we will not be beaten. We will learn how to win on the COVID battlefield.